There's no feeling more intense than starting over. If you deleted your homework the day before it was due, as I have, or if you left your wallet at home and you have to go back after spending an hour in the computer, if you won some money at the casino and then put all your winnings on red but it came up black, if you got your best shirt dry cleaned before a wedding,
safe place to stop with the game. Don't worry, I'll save your progress always. This game is a homage to a free game that came out in 2006. The author of that game is Jazzy, a mysterious Czech designer who was known for his father of B games. B games are rough assemblages of map objects. Designers slap them together very quickly and freely, and they're often too rough. They're built more for the joy of building than it's not. In a certain way, Sexy Hiking is the perfect embodiment of the game. It's built almost entirely out of bound on the side of violence, and it's one of the most unusual and unfriendly games of its time. In it, your task is simply to drag yourself up a mountain by hand. That act of climbing, in the digital world or in real life, has certain essential problems. No amount of forward progress is guaranteed. Obstacles in video game worlds are fake. You can be completely confident in your ability to get through them once you have the correct method or the correct equipment just by spending enough time. In that sense, every pixelated obstacle in Sexy Hiking is real.
obstacles in sexy hiking are unyielding, and that makes the game unique and frustrating. But I'm not sure Jezero intended to make it frustrating. Frustration is just essential to the act of climbing, and it's authentic to the process of building a game about it. A funny thing happened to me as I was building this map. I'd have an idea for a new obstacle, and I'd build it, test it, and it would usually turn out to be unreasonably hard. But I couldn't bring myself to make it easier. It already felt like my inability to get past the new obstacle was my fault, as a player rather than as a builder. Imaginary mountains built themselves from our efforts to climb, and it's our repeated attempts to reach the summit that turns those mountains into something real. You're building a video game world, you're building with ideas. And that can be like working with quickset cement. You mold your ideas into a certain shape that can be played with. And in the process of playing with them, they begin to harden and set until they're immutable like rock. And at that point, you can unchange them. Not without breaking it into pieces and starting fresh with your ideas.
Thank you.
objects in the stores are trash. I don't mean they look bad or they're badly made. I mean they're trash in the way that food becomes trash as soon as you put it in the sink. Things are made to be consumed and used in a certain context. And once the moment is gone, they transform into it. In the context of technology, those moments pass by in seconds. This is what digital culture is. A monstrous mountain of trash, the ash heap of creativity's found. A landfill with everything we ever thought of in it. Grand, infinite, and unsweet. Of McRibs, discarded, forgotten, unrecycled, muddled, rotten, untitled. Everything's fresh for about 6 seconds, until some newer thing beckons, and we hit refresh. And there's years of persevering, disappearing into the pile, out of style, out of sight.
attempting to make friendly content that's gentle, that lets you churn through it, but not add. Why make something demanding if it just gets piled up in the land, filed in?
Oh,